Oh, it's one of those inconveniences that seem to come at the worst time.
A busy intersection on your way to work or to the store has a broken stoplight. Cars have to alternate, and it takes forever to get through. So what causes traffic lights to go out? Good question. John Lauritsen looked into that and the sometimes painful process of turning them back on.
I've been stuck during traffic.
Plenty.
How much fun is that?
No fun at all.
And there are different kinds of stuck. A stalled vehicle, a slow merge, rush hour gridlock.
Like, I only live 2 miles from here, but sometimes it can take 30 minutes to get there.
For 3 days this week, Minneapolis drivers had to put on the brakes at 2nd Avenue and 11th Street. The signal went out Monday night and didn't get fixed until today.
I think everyone around the intersection is looking at each other confused, not knowing what to do next.
People aren't really happy necessarily.
They aren't, especially when it goes into the day format, when it's not just hours, it's days.
Steve Mosing is the traffic operations engineer for the city of Minneapolis, and he's in charge of making sure the city's 806 traffic signals are running smoothly.
Well, sometimes you have a power outage that will be really brief and quick, and for that reason, a signal will go to flash as a precaution, a safety precaution.
Along with a power surge, rainy weather can cause moisture buildup inside the cabinet where the signal controller is stored, causing the lights to go into flash mode. But the reason the signals were out on this street is one of the most common reasons traffic signals go out.
Usually it's a car has hit it.
If a car hits the cabinet hard enough, the wiring and everything inside needs to be rebuilt before the signals can come back on.
What we do is once we rebuild the controller, we test the controller for a day or two to make sure that it's going to operate correctly out in the field before we install it.
That's what happened in this case. It's not just time for drivers, it's money too. They're responsible for paying the damage. And it's never cheap.
This costs thousands of dollars in damage.
Yeah, a controller, again, which is the intelligence at the intersection, can cost up to $50,000-$60,000 sometimes.
Mosing says that each controller is different. It generally takes up to 48 hours to test a rebuilt signal controller before it can begin working. If you have a good question for John, please email it by going to WCCO.com/links.